Hey fellow beauty finders, thanks for clicking on my new video. So my name is Mathias Allen and I am a professional working makeup artist. Now if you're new to my channel, I do 3 weekly demos. I do Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. I do sit down interviews with fellow artists. I do makeup hauls, product reviews, and I bring you behind the scenes with me on photo shoots and with my celebrity clients. Over my 15-year career, I've been an educator for many big brands. I've worked for Makeup Forever, NARS, Smashbox, and Kevin Aucoin Beauty, just to name a few. And I've flown all over the country teaching at spas, salons, and makeup academies. Over the course of the next few weeks, I'm going to be taking you behind the scenes with me to a class I held up in San Francisco based on celebrity red carpet makeup. Now, now we're gonna focus on skin. Now the eyes are done, and like I said, I always do the eyes first and then clean up under the eye with eye cream, because then I can go right into skin and not worry about anything underneath that's fallen. And if I have done eyeshadow last or second, you always get that fallout and it's really hard to fix it and make it look better. So what I like to do is I like to take 2 different foundations, and I usually tend to custom blend right on my palette and create like the foundation look that I want. Another thing that I like to do to really emphasize the glow is use like a glowing lotion or a potion and mix that in with my product. So this is from Face Atelier. It's a kind of bronzy peach glow lotion. It's a silicone based product, which means it's gonna last a really long time. Right now, today I'm using Face Atelier, but I've used all different brands and all different types. So many. If you go to my YouTube channel, like I said, you'll see a dozen different types.
Obviously, she doesn't need concealer, but would you say concealer?
Obviously, everybody needs concealer.
So you're gonna do concealer too?
Oh yeah.
So you don't do it first?
No. Now, it's really important to use a primer on the skin after your moisturizer, because primers will contain the moisturizer in the skin. It'll keep everything that's moisturizing on the inside and keep your foundation on the outside. So I always use a primer on the skin before I put any foundation on. So anything that's silicone based will tend to stay on the surface, because like I said at the beginning, your skin is a sponge and it will start to drink stuff. So if it's a silicone based product on top, it tends to last longer because it can't get in. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with the lighter of the 2 foundations first, and we're gonna go right on top of her cheekbone like this. And I'm using a foundation brush. It's really important, I think, to use a foundation brush other than your fingers, because your fingers will just smear and put things on too heavy. And if you have a foundation brush, you will just look like you've had your makeup done by a makeup artist, more so than if you're using your fingers. So let me put that on. I kind of will highlight with the lighter of the 2 foundations first. So highlighting means putting it in the T-zone and then putting it down the center of the face, like the chin. Okay, so then I go in with the second color, and I'm gonna start here in the middle. What's that? I'm doing the light first. So I did the light in the T-zone, across the cheekbones and down the center of the face. And then I'm doing the darker of the 2 shades, like in the middle of the cheek where I would contour, along the jawline, across the temple, across the forehead. Then, like I said, I start to custom blend on her face. So, you know, I'm looking at her face and I'm seeing where the light went, and I thought, oh, well, you know what, I should probably custom blend, do a little bit more color, like right in here, kind of put it right on top, put a little on her lip. Then this is where I go, have her stick her chin up, and I bring that color down the center to warm up her neck. Because we want to make sure that she has the same color throughout. Okay, so I'm gonna take my beauty sponge. This is from Isom. This is a pro finishing sponge from Isom, and I love it because I love the way that it's cut and the angles of it. And I'm gonna just wet it slightly with the hydrating mist from Jane Iredell. And the reason I wet it is because I don't want it to eat the foundation as I use it to blend. I want it to soften lightly, and if you have a slightly damp sponge, it will help blend the product into the skin like so. But like a sponge, like your skin is a sponge, if it's dry, it's gonna start to eat and suck everything up. So by lightly hydrating it, you're gonna get a blending application. You know, I'm softening the look, I'm kind of removing some product from her face, but I'm not trying to remove all of it from her face. So that's why I chose to wet the sponge slightly. Okay, so what do we think of the way that looks from where you're sitting? Because I'm, you know, this close.
The only thing though for me, moist on me, would, I would think it would make me look blunt. I would want to not have shiny, because then I...
Well, then that's a personal preference. You know, my mom to this day is like, I have oily skin. I'm like, Mom, you went through menopause 15 years ago. You are no longer oily. But she hates being greasy or shiny. It's just something in her head from the 60s when she was oily and shiny. She doesn't like that. I personally feel that once you're past 40, you should have more shine because your skin doesn't tend to have shine in it. It does dry out. We all dry out from pollutants in the air, from you know, everything. So I think hydrated skin makes you look younger because it gives the illusion that you're still pre-menopause or you're still 25 and your skin is naturally, you know, glowing.
If you're brand new to my YouTube channel, please subscribe. I do weekly pro artist tips and tricks, including this 10-part celebrity red carpet series, in which you'll learn many of my secrets and how I get my celebrities to look fantastic on the red carpet, including lash application, highlighting, contouring, and much, much more. If you'd like to book me as a celebrity makeup artist expert in your part of the country, please email me mathias@mathiasformakeup.com and we can talk about my rates and my availability. Now I'm going to be releasing the series in different parts on a week-to-week basis, and I'm going to show you exactly how to get my celebrity red carpet look. So I hope you guys enjoyed this sneak peek into one of my red carpet classes. If you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up tab and leave me a comment down below. Now if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do so now by clicking on this link, because I do 3 weekly demos. And if you're not already following me on social media, please do @mathiasformakeup. And before you guys go, if you missed any other part of this series, please click on one of these 2 links and you will see one of my other red carpet classes. All right, thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.